ろしくお願いします。
おはようございます。
おはようございます。
So, I'm Dr. Rajiv from India. I'm fellow at Yorkshire Medical Q, and I'll be talking on intragastric balloon overview and results. The 2016 WHO report suggests that there are 1.9 billion people who are overweight. Another 650 million are obese. Obesity increases diabetes mellitus, hypertension, coronary artery disease, sleep apnea, stroke, gastroesophageal reflux disease, gallbladder disease, certain cancers, and non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So what are the treatment options available? Lifestyle modification, diet, exercise, pharmacotherapy, and surgery. Surgery is the most effective and most durable treatment option available. However, less than 1% of the population which is eligible for surgery undergo surgery. Reasons being cost, accessibility, complications, and patient preference. So at one end of the spectrum, we have medical therapy. The other end is surgical therapy. And what we need is a bridge between the two, which is intragastric balloon. Garen Edwards gave the first gastric bubble in 1985 in USA. It was made of polyurethane, cylindrical in shape, could take 200 to 220 ml of air. However, complications like spontaneous deflation leading to small bowel obstruction and gastric mucosal injury led to disrepute. So what are the indications? Can be used for preemptive therapy, metabolic therapy, primary therapy. In preemptive, with a BMI more than 30, at risk of disease development, at risk for high all-cause mortality, and with high cardiovascular risk profile. In BMI more than 30 with hyperlipidemia, diabetes mellitus type 2, and hypertension, and primary therapy for BMI more than 35, or BMI more than 40 as a preparation for major bariatric surgery, or patients who are not wanting surgery. So these are some of the balloons available. Orbera from the US, SPATS adjustable balloon, reshaped duo, Oblon, then Ellipse, Heliosphere, Siliment from Brazil, Metzil from Russia, Endalis from France, and Easy Life from France. Orbera is the oldest balloon available commercially. Manufactured by Apollo Endosurgery USA, previously it was known as BioEntrix Intragastric Balloon. Made of silicone, takes about 450 to 700 ml of saline plus methylene blue and can be used for 6 months. It's FDA approved from 2015. The reshaped duo, again from USA, has two balloons. Take 450 ml of saline each, connected by a tube, so if one ruptures, the other can sustain the location in the stomach. Can be used for 6 months. FDA approval in July 2015. The SPATS adjustable balloon, again from USA, it takes about 400 to 800 ml of saline with methylene blue. Can be used for 12 months, has CE approval, and it is the only adjustable balloon, the only adjustable balloon that we have. Ellipse, manufactured by Allurion, it is a procedureless balloon. It can be swallowed. It is self-draining, and it's naturally expelled after 4 months. Obelon, by USA, it is a swallowable balloon, takes 250 ml of air. It's FDA approved, and up to 3 can be used over a period of 6 months. Heliosphere bag from France. It is a double backed polymer with an external silicone pouch. Takes about 700 ml of air, and total weight is less than 30 gram. Can be removed after 6 months. So how do they work? Weight loss, comorbidity resolution, and alterations in GI hormones. Weight loss. They studied Orbera balloon therapy, and it was found to have a mean weight loss of about 10.5 to 13.7 kg in 3 months, and 13 to 26.3 kg in 6 months. The excess weight loss at 3 months after removal was found between 14 to 50.9%, and excess weight loss at 12 months after the removal was found to be 14.2 to 27.2%. Orbera was most effective during the first 3 months of placement, with 80% weight loss achieved reduction in the first 3 months. Insertion of second Orbera balloon was not difficult and achieved good results, with a percent excess weight loss being 31.5 to 23.2. ReShape Duo has a total body weight reduction of 16.6 plus minus of 9.33 kg at 6 months. A mean excess weight loss of 31.8% at 6 months. 64% of the total reduced weight was maintained at 6 months post removal. SPATS 3 adjustable balloon showed a mean weight loss of 15.6 kg at 24 weeks and 24.4 kg at 52 weeks. A small observational investigation in 73 patients has showed 45.7% of excess weight loss at 12 months post placement. We have studied comorbidity in Orbera resolution. The metabolic syndrome was 34.8% at insertion, and it reduced to 14.5% after 6 months. At 6 months follow-up, it further reduced to 13%, and at 1 year of follow-up, it further reduced to 11.6%. Similarly, diabetes type 2 resolved from 32.6% to 20.9% at 6 months, 22.5% at 6 months follow-up, and 21.3% at 1 year follow-up. There was not significant change in hyperuricemia, going from 26 to 24.4 to 25.9 and to 26.4. Hypertriglyceridemia reduced from 37.7% at insertion of Orbera to 14.5% at 6 months, 15.2% at 6 months follow-up, and 17.4% at 1 year of follow-up. Hypercholesterolemia was 33.4% at insertion, reduced to 16.7% at 6 months, 16.7% at 6 months follow-up, and 18.9% at 1 year of follow-up. Obstructive sleep apnea is a major risk factor with obesity, with a prevalence of 50 to 60%. 17 patients with severe OSA underwent Orbera insertion for a period of 6 months, and neck circumference decreased from 51.1 cm to 47.9 cm. So there was a nearly complete resolution of obstructive sleep apnea, as evidenced by decrease in the apnea-hypopnea sleep index from 52.1 to 14 events per hour. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It affects about 70% of the obese population, and 18 patients with histologically proven NASH underwent Orbera insertion. At 6 months, there was significant reduction in the mean BMI and superior improvement in non-alcoholic fatty liver disease activity scores. Infertility is linked to obesity in females. So 110 obese infertile women were evaluated for effectiveness of weight loss with the Orbera balloon and surgical techniques including adjustable gastric bind, sleeve gastrectomy and gastric bypass in restoring fertility. All procedures were effective in reversing infertility with no significant difference between them. So we have a clinical dilemma. Since Orbera is the oldest balloon, most of the literature available is on Orbera, previously the BioEntrix intragastric balloon. So how to choose the balloon for your patient? Depending on good response, success rate, weight loss comparable to bariatric surgery, and effective comorbidity resolution. So I will share a recent FDA trial of PATCH 3. The report had investigated Obelon, Reshape, Orbera, a transpyloric shuttle, and SPATCH 3 on various parameters. The first is response or success rate, which is defined by more than 10% of total body weight loss or more than 25% of excess weight loss. So Obelon had 24.7%, which is less than 25% excess weight loss. Reshape had 48.8, Orbera had 46.4, and transpyloric shuttle with 38.7. SPATCH 3 achieved the highest weight loss reduction, with percentage excess weight loss being 83.7. The percentage total body weight loss with Obelon was 6.6%, Reshape 6.8, Orbera 10.2, transpyloric shuttle 9.4. Again, highest with SPATCH 3, 14.9%. The excess weight loss with Obelon was 24.1, which is less than 25. With Reshape 25.1, Orbera 38%, a transpyloric shuttle 30.2, and again with SPATCH 3 highest, 52.9. When we talk of weight loss, Obelon achieved a weight loss of 14.4 pounds. Reshape achieved a weight loss of 14.3 pounds. Orbera achieved a weight loss of 21.8 pounds. Transpyloric shuttle achieved a weight loss of 20.5 pounds. And SPATCH 3 achieved maximum weight loss of 31.7 pounds. Now the additional advantage with SPATCH 3 is that it is adjustable. So after the first 9 months, you can increase the volume in SPATCH 3. And that feature is not available in any other balloon. And it achieves an additional weight loss, excess weight loss of 14.7%. That's all. Arigato gozaimashita.
Arigato gozaimashita.